career and technical education is something that we must support. Even though we are a part of career and technical education, we have to be serious about supporting all of career and technical education, because our very existence depends upon it. And so that's why we support ACTE. And what I want to suggest to you this morning is that we need to value more than ever before the relationship that we have as NAAE members, as agricultural educators, the relationship that we have with ACTE. ACTE is our voice in Washington, D.C. And so more than ever before, we need to be supporters of advocacy efforts, not just for agricultural education, but for all of career and technical education, because we're a part of CTE. ACTE needs us. But you know what? We need ACTE. What we need ACTE for is advocacy. And as long as they're delivering advocacy messages in Washington, D.C., and helping our states do the same in state legislatures, we must support ACTE. They are our voice. Strength comes in numbers. And so they need to be able to go to Washington, D.C. and say, we represent all of these thousands of career and technical educators, and we can provide, should be providing, 12,000 members of ACTE. We should be adding to those numbers in that way. And so I hope I can impress on you this morning the importance of ACTE, why we need to go back home, share with our state associations that we need to support ACTE, and I hope we can do that.